Hello everyone, welcome to the class of Rankine Cycle. In the previous lecture of plant, we have covered boiler classification, mounting accessories on the YouTube course. Okay, and today I'm going to start with Rankine Cycle. So as you know that our YouTube course for RBSCJ is going on, and in that we are covering some important lectures. Okay, for each and every subjects. So today from the subject of power plant, I'm going to start with Rankine Cycle. Now this Rankine Cycle is very very important. You all know that the working cycle of steam power plant is Rankine cycle. It is the working cycle of steam power plant. Okay. Well, steam power plant is also a kind of heat engine. It is also a kind of heat engine. Now the question is, why for the steam power plant Carnot cycle, which is a standard cycle of the heat engine, is not used as the working cycle? Why we have to design a new cycle which is Rankine cycle? Why not the Carnot cycle is used for the as a working cycle of steam power plant? Because for most of the engines, the standard cycle is Carnot cycle. The reason why Carnot cycle cannot be used for steam power plant, suppose Carnot cycle is used here. Carnot cycle, you know that in the Carnot cycle, there are basically four process, two isothermal and two isentropic. Now, if you represent a Carnot cycle on a TS diagram, that is temperature entropy diagram, if you see this, so this is a Carnot cycle. Now, if the Carnot cycle is used as a working cycle of steam power plant, you can understand from this thing that in the Rankine cycle, in the steam power plant, there are basically four components, important components: pump, boiler, turbine, and condenser. This is compression, okay, and this is the heat addition, then this is expansion, and then this is heat rejection. Now, if Carnot cycle has to be used as the working cycle of steam power plant, then what will happen? If this is a turbine expansion in the turbine, if this is a turbine expansion, then you can see that if this dome is for a liquid vapor dome for the water, this is saturated liquid region. And this is the liquid plus vapor region, and this is a saturated vapor region or saturated vapor line. Now, turbine, in the turbine what happens? The steam is expanded in the turbine, okay. Now, and due to expansion of the steam in the turbine, the shaft of the turbine is connected to the shaft of the generator, and then electricity will be produced by rotation of the shaft of the generator. If turbine is handling, in the output of the boiler is the saturated vapor. Now you can see, at the output of the boiler it is saturated vapor. But in the expansion of the turbine, if it is Carnot cycle, it is expansion is taking place in this region, liquid plus vapor region. If Carnot cycle is used as a working cycle, then turbine has to do expansion in the liquid and vapor region, and in that case, turbine has to handle liquid along with vapor. Now we know that in the turbine what happens, the steam used to rotate the blades of the turbine. Now if only saturated steam goes into the turbine, then it will be no problem. But if liquid plus vapor both goes into the blades of turbine, then it can cause erosion in blades of turbine. Okay, so that is a very big problem. So to avoid it, we normally do not use Carnot cycle. This is one of the reason. Another reason is that if this is a compression is also handling two liquids, liquid and vapor, two phases are handled in the compression. That is also very difficult. Okay, because for compression, you should have dry compression. And if liquid is also present, then it will also not good for the compressor or for the pump. okay, because pump handles only liquid for compression, not gases. Okay, so this is also a problem. So to avoid this problem, we do not use Carnot cycle as a working cycle of Rankine cycle or the steam power plant. We use Rankine cycle. Okay, so in the Rankine cycle, what we do is, first of all, Rankine cycle consists of basically four important components: pump, and from the pump there is, after the pump, pump pumps up water to the boiler. Okay, the purpose of using the pump is just to pump the water from the normal pressure to the boiler pressure. Okay, and from that water which is pumped to the pump, the boiler will convert the supply heat into the boiler, and it will convert the water into the steam. This steam will be expanded in a turbine. Okay, it will be expanded in a turbine, and from the turbine, this steam will go into the exit of the turbine. The steam will go into a condenser. In the condenser, what will happen? Condensation process will happen. Okay, and the steam which is at the exit of the turbine will be condensed, and it will be changed into, from saturated vapor, it will be changed into saturated liquid, and then it will be sent to the pump again. Okay. So these are basically the four important components of the steam power plant. Okay, apart from that, there are more components we have studied in the previous lecture. There are some boiler accessories also. Okay, there is a feed pump, feed water heater. Okay, so there are some other components also that we will discuss today. See, this is the four components. This is a schematic diagram of a steam power plant. Now, if you represent the Rankine cycle, if you have to represent the Rankine cycle on a temperature entropy diagram, how we will represent the Rankine cycle on temperature entropy diagram? So, in the Carnot cycle, we are doing two isothermal and two isentropic process, right? In the Rankine cycle, we will be doing two isentropic and two constant pressure process. Okay, so first is pump work, which is isentropic compression the pump. Then from this, the pump will supply the water to the boiler pressure, and in the boiler, the heat addition will take place. Okay, so heating will take place at constant pressure, and normally at the exit of the pump, at the exit of the boiler, the steam is not, is steam is in the superheated region. Okay, so this region at the exit of the boiler, the steam is in the superheated region. Okay, and this superheated steam get expanded into the turbine. Okay, and after expansion the turbine, the heat rejection will take place in the condenser at constant pressure. Okay, so these are the four process on the, for the Rankine cycle on the TS diagram. So basically it consists of four process. 1-2-2 is isentropic compression in the pump, then 2-3 is constant pressure heat addition, pressure heat addition in the boiler, then 3-4 is again isentropic expansion in turbine, and 4-1 is constant pressure heat rejection in the condenser. Okay, so these are the normally four processes which take place in the Rankine cycle, and these are represented in this diagram. Now, if we apply the energy, or if we do a steady flow energy analysis of this, all the components, you all have studied steady flow energy equation in thermodynamics subject. Okay, so if you apply the steady flow for all the parts, that is for pump, heat transfer will be equal to 0, because in the pump there is no heat transfer, we only supply the work as input. So that pump work will be equal to H2 minus H1. Okay. Now after pump it is a boiler. In the boiler we supply the heat. Okay, so here in the boiler work will be zero because we are not supplying any work. We are actually supplying the heat, which is equal to H3 minus H2. H2. In the turbine, we are getting work output from the turbine. So there will be no heat transfer. It is insulated. Okay. And it is adiabatic. So work output from the turbine is equal to S3 minus H4. And in the condenser, there is no work output. So work output is zero and we are getting only heat transfer is going on, which is equal to H4 minus H1. Okay, so this is the energy analysis of all the four components of the steam power plant. Okay, so you have to remember this thing that if you have to calculate the work of pump, it is equal to H2 minus H1. Heat transfer in the boiler is equal to H3 minus H2. Work by turbine is H3 minus H4 and heat rejected in the condenser is H4 minus H1. Okay. This pump work is also equal to minus of V into dP. Okay. This is the formula for pump work because pump is the open system. So, it is also equal to minus V dP. Okay. And this pump work is also a very, very small work. If we compare the steam power plant and gas turbine power plant, in the steam power plant, it consists of all the four components are same. That is, it consists of turbine and it consists of combustion chamber, condenser. Okay. But in the case of gas turbine power plant, it consists of a compressor. And here it consists of a pump. Pump work in the case of steam power plant is very, very small. As we know that pump work and compressor work both are the work input. They are the input work. And the input work in case of a steam power plant is very, very small because we don't have to supply much work. So, efficiency of the steam power plant is more as compared to gas turbine power plant because lesser is the work input that has to be supplied and more is the work output, more will be the efficiency. Okay. Now, if we have to find the efficiency of this Rankine cycle, how we can find the efficiency? Efficiency is equal to work done over heat supplied. This is a formula for efficiency. Work done is equal to our net work. It is also equal to net work over heat supplied. Net work is equal to, this is the turbine work, this is the pump work. Net work is equal to turbine work minus of pump work over heat supplied. It is equal to turbine work minus pump work over heat supplied. So, if you apply this, put these values here, then in that case efficiency will be equal to turbine work minus pump work over heat supplied. What is turbine work? It is equal to H3 minus H4 minus times of pump work, which is H2 minus H1 over heat supplied. What is heat supplied here? Heat supplied is in the boiler, which is H3 minus H2. So, this is the formula for efficiency of a Rankine cycle. Okay. So, efficiency of the Rankine cycle is equal to turbine work minus pump work, because pump work is a negative work. So, it will be minus times pump work over H3 minus H2. This is the formula to calculate the efficiency of a Rankine cycle. Okay. Now, in this Rankine cycle, there is a term called, we know that net work is equal to turbine work minus compressor work. Net work is equal to turbine work minus, sorry, pump work. Okay, so net work is equal to work done by turbine minus work input to the pump. This is also equal to net work. So, there is a term called steam rate. There is a term called steam rate, which is equal to amount of steam which is consumed to supply the net work output in the case of Rankine cycle. That is called steam rate, or the rate at which steam is supplied to produce the net work output from the steam power plant. That is called steam rate, which is equal to 3600 over network. And the unit is kilogram per kilowatt hour. Okay, that is the formula for finding the steam rate, which is equal to 3600 network. Network will be turbine work minus pump work. So, this is the formula for finding the steam rate. And this is used in the exam. You have to take care of the units also. It is kilogram per kilowatt hour. Okay, so it is in kilogram per kilowatt hour. That's why it is 3600 here. Okay. So, normally the steam rate is equal to, steam rate is have the formula of 1 by network. It is equal to 1 by network in kilogram per kilowatt second. But the steam rate is generally measured in the form of kilogram per kilowatt hour. Okay, so that is the formula in terms of kilogram per kilowatt hour. You have to multiply by 3600. Okay, so this is how you will get the formula for steam rate. Okay, in kilogram per kilowatt hour. Now, in the steam power plant or in the Rankine cycle, this we have find the efficiency. And we also found the what is steam rate. But in the steam power plant, there are two important things. One is reheat Rankine cycle and the regeneration Rankine cycle. What is this reheating and regeneration? Okay. So, Rankine cycle with reheat. First of all, what is the meaning of reheat? Reheating means heating again. Again, heating is called reheating. So, when are we heating again? When we need to reheat the reheat again. What is the purpose of that thing? At the outlet of the turbine, if you will notice, if the, suppose that this is suppose at the outlet of the turbine, the steam at the outlet turbine is in the liquid plus vapor region. So, the quality of the steam will be very, very low. Because what is the meaning of quality? Quality means, quality of the steam means dryness fraction. Dryness fraction means the quality of the steam. Okay. So, the reason why we don't use Carnot cycle in the turbine for the steam power plant is because the turbine has to handle liquid plus vapor and it will cause erosion on the blades of the turbine. So, that's why we require the quality of the steam to be very, very high, or dryness fraction should be high. Okay. So, at this point dryness fraction is x is equal to 0 and at this point x it is equal to 1 and your dryness fraction should be high as possible. Okay. So, how we can increase the dryness fraction? Dryness fraction which is equal to mass of vapor over mass of vapor plus mass of liquid. Okay, this is called dryness fraction. So, the more is the dryness fraction, more will be the quality of the steam from the outlet of the turbine. So, reheating is basically done to increase the dryness fraction and also it increases the work output of the turbine. Okay. So, there are two purposes of reheating in the Rankine cycle: to increase the dryness fraction and to increase the net work output of the turbine. So, how we can increase the dryness fraction? So, in the case of reheat cycle, what we do, suppose this is your boiler, this is your pump, okay, and after the pump, it will, the water will go into the boiler. Now, from the boiler, this will go into the turbine. Normally, it goes into the turbine. Now, in the reheat cycle, Rankine cycle with reheat, the steam will firstly go into the high pressure turbine, and after going from through the high pressure turbine, some of the steam, normally what happens, after going to the turbine, its steam goes into the condenser, okay, and in the condenser, the condensation process takes place, steam gets converted into liquid, okay.
But in the reheat cycle, what we do, the quality of the steam coming out of the high pressure turbine can be improved by sending it to the, firstly it is sent to the boiler. In the boiler, it is, this steam gets heated up again. This is called reheating also. And this, after reheating, it is again sent back to a low pressure turbine for expansion. For further expansion, it is sent to the low pressure turbine. Low pressure turbine. And from the low pressure turbine, this steam will go normally to the condenser, like it goes to the condenser. And then it will be sent to the pump. So, in the case of reheating with Rankine cycle, we do heating in two stages. First stage was in boiler. Second stage, the turbine output from the high pressure turbine, steam from the high pressure turbine output or exit is sent back to the boiler, again heated up, and then the quality of the steam will improve. Why? Because dryness fraction is equal to mass of vapor over mass of vapor plus liquid. Okay. So, how we can increase the dryness fraction? If we can increase the mass of vapor. Okay. And mass of vapor can be increased if from the output of the steam, we can again heat the steam coming out of the output of the high pressure turbine, again heating it and then again sending it to the low pressure turbine, and it then is go to the condenser. Okay. So, this is how this reheating will take place. Okay. And if we have to plot it on a Rankine cycle, this will be represented like this. Okay. So, this is one, process one, two, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so this is the Rankine cycle with reheating. You can see this is a reheating done here. Okay, so this is the first stage of expansion. Sorry. Then this is reheating again. And this is the second stage of expansion. Okay, so this is now in the case of reheating, what we are doing, we are increasing the quality. Normally, if this expansion would have been like this, the quality of the steam would have been at this place and the quality is low. But due to reheating, the quality of the steam is now more as compared to the previous case. Okay, so this is the purpose of reheating, to increase the quality of the steam at the exit of the turbine. And also, if you can see here, the with reheating, what is the net work? Heat supplied. Heat supplied is now equal to H3 minus H2 plus H5 minus H4. Heat supplied has also increased. And turbine work has also increased from H3 minus H4 plus H5 minus H6. This is the turbine work. Pump work will be same. It will be the same. Okay. So, with reheating, the heat supplied and turbine work both has increased. Okay. So, we cannot say that reheating will increase the efficiency, because although pump work is same, but and turbine work has increased, but heat supplied has also increased. So, with reheating in Rankine cycle, only 4 to 5% increase in efficiency take place, this which is a very less amount. Okay, so mostly with reheating in Rankine cycle, efficiency is not that much affected, but turbine work and heat supplied increases and quality of the steam also increases. So this question can come in the exam, that what is the purpose of reheating in the steam power plant? It increases the quality of the steam and also increases the turbine work and heat supplied. Okay. And the last case is Rankine cycle with regeneration. What is regeneration? Rankine cycle with regeneration. regeneration, like I had told you, to understand the meaning of reheat, what is the meaning of regeneration? You have to understand the meaning of regeneration also. Regenerate means to reproduce something, to again produce something. So normally what happens in the steam power plant, the steam at the exit of the turbine normally goes into the condenser, and from the condenser it will be again converted into again supplied back to the pump. But what we normally do, we do not utilize the heat of the steam. We do not 100% utilize the heat of the steam, because after expansion the turbine, we don't take care of, it is normally wasted. The heat of the steam is normally wasted by condensation. So in the regeneration principle, we utilize that heat. We utilize the heat of the steam, and we normally, what we do, we utilize that heat of the steam and send it back to the a heater, which is called feed water heater. In the feed water heater, which it will heat the feed water which has to be supplied to the boiler. Okay. So what will happen if we somehow reduce the heat which is supplied in the boiler, efficiency which is equal to work done by heat supplied, if this increases, efficiency will increase. Okay. So with regeneration, what we do, we reduce the heat that has to be supplied in the boiler. Okay, and we do that with the help of a feed water heater. A feed water heater is also a boiler accessory. It is also a boiler accessories. We have discussed boiler accessories in the previous lecture. That is super heater, economizer, air preheater. This is also a boiler accessories, because it reduces the heat that has to be supplied in the boiler. And how this, but the difference between feed water heater and economizer, air preheater and superheater was that economizer, air preheater and superheater were boiler accessories which gets their heat input from flue gases. But feed water heater gets the heat input from steam bled from turbine. Steam bled from turbine. Okay, so source of heat to the feed water heater is not the flue gas, but the steam which is bled or taken from the turbine. So normally what we do in the regeneration, normally what happens? This thing happens, okay. In the turbine, expansion take place and then it will send to the condenser. But we do not utilize the steam after expansion. It is sent to the condenser and the heat of the steam is rejected as such. So what we do, we will extract some heat from this point of the turbine. Okay. And this heat of the turbine, this taking out steam from the turbine is called as bleeding. Okay, so bleeding is the word which is used mostly in the regeneration case. Bleeding is called as, and bleeding is only used in the steam power plant. We don't use this word for gas turbine power plant. Although in the Brayton cycle, we use regeneration, but that in there we don't call it bleeding, because bleeding means extracting some heat from the turbine in the midway. That is why it is called bleeding. Extracting steam from turbine. Extracting steam from the turbine is called bleeding. So, in the steam power plant, in the regeneration, we bled out some steam from the turbine and utilize that steam to heat the feed water. In the pump, what is pump is doing? The pump is pumping the water to the boiler. And in the boiler, heat is supplied to convert the water into steam. Okay. So, if we directly put the, send the feed water to the boiler, boiler has to supply more heat to convert the water into steam. But, if the feed water is heated up by the feed water heater, then less heat has to be supplied by the boiler. Okay. And we can reduce the heat that has to be supplied in the boiler. Okay. So, here at this point, a feed water heater is used. This feed water heater will utilize the steam or heat of the steam. It will heat the feed water which is sent by the pump. Okay. And in this way, what will happen? Less heat has to be supplied by the boiler. Now, this feed water are also of two types. They are open feed water heater and closed feed water heater. Okay. Feed water heater are of two types. Open feed water heater and closed feed water heater. Open and closed. In the open feed water heater, the feed water and the steam will directly mix with each other. There will be a direct mixing of the feed water and the steam which is bled from the turbine. Okay. But in the case of closed feed water heater, there will be no direct mixing. Okay. Mixing is not direct. Okay. There will be no direct exchange of heat between the heat exchanger, feed water heater and the steam which is taken from the turbine. Okay. So, that is the difference between open and closed feed water heater. And normally we apply the combination of open and closed feed water heater in the power plant. Okay. So, let us see with the help of a diagram how we do regeneration. So, suppose this is your pump. Now, pump has supplied some water. Now, this water will not go directly into the boiler. Normally, it goes into the boiler. Now, it will go into the feed water heater first. Suppose it is open feed water heater. Okay. So, now the water or feed water has goes into the open feed water heater. Now, this steam for this, the heat for this open feed water heater is taken from the turbine. Okay. Suppose this is the heat taken, and now the what will happen? The feed water which is sent by the pump 1, this is pump 1. It will heat the feed water sent from the pump 1 and it will convert this feed water heater at high temperature. It will not change the, it will not change water into steam. It will only heat the water. Okay, normally the water which was having temperature of 25 degrees Celsius, now the temperature will be around 60 degrees Celsius, 60 to 70. Now this high temperature water will be sent back to a pump, which is pump 2 at state 3, and at state 4 it is sent to the boiler. Okay. Now, after the boiler, what will happen? It will send the steam to the turbine. Okay, and from the turbine, what we are doing? We are bleeding some steam for the open feed water heater, and rest of the steam is sent to the condenser. And this is sent to the pump 1 again. Okay, so if this is 4, this will be 5, this will be 6, this will be 7. Okay. So, this is how our regeneration work. Okay. So, what we are doing in this regeneration, we are regenerating the steam and utilizing the steam for heating the feed water heater or feed water in the feed water heater. Okay. Now, if we have to draw this diagram of Rankine cycle with regeneration, suppose 1 kg of steam was sent by the boiler to the turbine, and if we remove y kg of steam, if y kg of steam is bled to the feed water heater, okay, so 1 minus y kg will be sent to the condenser. 1 minus y kg steam will be sent to the condenser. Suppose mass of steam which is sent by the boiler is 1 kg to the turbine, And if we have bled 5 kg of steam and sent it to the feed water heater, so rest of our steam will be 1 minus y kg, which will be sent to the condenser. Okay. So, let us draw this diagram. It is 1, 2, 2. So, what is happening here? We have taken some steam from this point. Suppose this is 1 kg and this is y kg. So, this is 1 minus y kg. Okay. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. So, this is the Rankine cycle for regeneration. And this is the open feed water heater. In the open feed water heater, suppose this feed water heater is at this point, there is a direct mixing of the steam and the feed water. That is why it is called open feed water heater. In the closed feed water heater, there will be not a direct mixing. Okay, the fluid and the water and the steam will not have a direct mixing with each other. That is closed feed water heater. Okay, so if you see here, the work output of the turbine is now equal to H5 minus H6 plus 1 minus Y times of H6 minus H7. This is the work output of the turbine, and work output of the pump is also now, suppose this is 1 minus Y, this is 1 minus Y of, okay, 1 minus Y kg of steam is now here, and this will be again 1 kg. Okay, so work output of the pump is also now equal to 1 minus y times of H2 minus H1 plus H4 minus H3. So, pump work is also increased. And heat supplied has now reduced. Now, the heat supplied is just H5 minus H4. Okay, it is equal to, because heat supplied in the boiler is now at this region. So, heat supplied is H5 minus H4. Okay. So, this is the how the, because this heat supplied in the feed water heater, it is not the heat supplied by its own. Okay. This is the heat taken from the steam. Okay. So, that will not the heat supplied that has to be supplied by the boiler. So, heat supplied has reduced now. Okay. Initially, the heat supplied was from this point to this point. Now, the heat supplied in the boiler is only this. Okay. So, heat supplied has reduced, and so efficiency of the Rankine cycle will increase. So, this is the purpose of regeneration, to increase the efficiency of the Rankine cycle. To increase the efficiency of the Rankine cycle. So, this was all about the Rankine cycle, and I hope it is clear to you. And so, you need to only understand that in the Rankine cycle, regeneration is done to increase the efficiency, and reheating is done to increase the quality of the steam at the output. Okay. So with reheating, we do not increase the efficiency. Efficiency only increases with regeneration. Okay. And we have also understood what is Rankine cycle, different process in the Rankine cycle, and how we calculate the efficiency of the Rankine cycle. Okay. So, I will meet you in the next lecture of Brayton cycle, that is tomorrow. Till then, you can keep practicing watching our videos on YouTube channel, and you can solve the numerical also from Rankine cycle. We can refer to any books. You can also solve the quiz of Rankine cycle from our GitHub app. Okay. So, I will meet you tomorrow. Till then, thank you and have a good day. Thank you.